Hello, my name is Father Jack Costello. I'm the rector of Epiphany Cathedral. Thank you for viewing our webpage and becoming more familiar with our faith community. Please join us. In this section of the webpage, I give a short reflection on the previous Sunday's gospel, which was the parable about the sower spreading out seed, and an enemy comes in the night and puts weeds among them, and the Lord says to let them grow together. One day a man was smiling as he was reading an article in the newspaper that said that women speak almost two times the amount of words than men do. It said here that men speak only about 15,000 words compared to women's 30,000 words. Without missing a beat, his wife said, "That's probably because we have to repeat everything to men." The husband turned to his wife and said, "What did you say?" People can be odd and sometimes very funny. I once knew a young person who was a strict vegetarian for reasons of health and world hunger, but who also smoked cigarettes like a chimney. One day I suggested, "You know, you might be healthier if you ate a cheeseburger now and then and gave up your smoking." The person responded, "You're probably right. I guess I'm just a bundle of contradictions." To which I responded, "Then welcome to the human race. We are all a mixture of weeds and wheat to one degree or another." Scripture scholars tell us that today's parable of the weed and the wheat was most likely told by St. Matthew to a church of his day as a reminder to the judgmental members in his community who were trying to draw rigid lines to keep the wrong people out of the church, instead of trying to follow Christ's example of drawing larger and wider circles to include all people into God's loving and forgiving embrace. In the parable, Jesus points out that human life is a lot like a field of wheat, not always neat and clean, and where people may not always be all good or all bad. Real life is simply not just all right or all wrong. Most often, it's a messy mixture that is incomplete, imperfect, and inconsistent. Family life, in all its messiness, governmental and political structures, human society, our religious institutions, and even our own souls are all part of this parable. If we only approach our faith as a series of rules and regulations, we can run the risk of losing the spirit of joy and the sense of hope that are central to the promise of the risen Christ and his good news. Some people can become so obsessed about pulling out the weeds that they forget to harvest the grain. Others can become so focused on the evil and abuses that surround us and threaten us that they fail to realize and celebrate the healing and life-giving presence of Christ in our midst. Some Christians have become so intent in upbraiding and punishing sinners that their own lives have become weighted down in gloom and condemnation. In other words, the parable reminds us that no matter who we are, in every person's wheat, there can be found a certain amount of weeds, or that our job is to avoid a holier-than-thou attitude, acting as if the garden of our own heart was totally free of any weeds at all. Judgment is never ours to pass on anyone, not even on ourselves. So we would all do well to look first to our own hearts and notice our own personal weeds, and remember to try to be a little bit more patient and tolerant with others, even as God is so patient and tolerant with us. Finally, the parable teaches us that we should always remain confident that God's gracious power will ultimately make all things work out right for our world, our church, our families, and our souls as well. Judgment belongs to God alone, and God will do so only at the end of a person's life, not in the middle of it. In the meantime, we are to work patiently and gently at removing our own weeds as best we can with God's help and God's grace. We are to strive to remain peaceful and tolerant with all people we meet this week. May we keep our eyes fixed on Jesus then, so that we can do that in the upcoming week, and ask him to give us the graces we need to do exactly that. Have a great week. God bless.